steam engines from China. The Retrol SE01, which I don't have, the Retrol SE02, which I do, has now been followed by the Retrol SE03. Following in the tradition of the German steam toys and modernized. This was fantastic. I got this from Stirligkit and Retrol. And you guys, when I get engines from Chinese retailers, you tend to not watch the video so much or think that, well, I'm going to say good things because I like getting the toys. Well, I do like getting the toys, but I think those days are over, except for YouTubers who have many hundreds of thousands of views, because YouTube views for long format videos are way, way down. So, and the fact is, I think this is a fantastic engine. And Retrol has now released SE03. I don't think it's come up on Stirligkit yet, but I expect it will. In fact, it isn't even on the Retrol site itself. So if we look at some of the things that made this so good, we've got a really nice rendition of the Stevenson's reversing. We've got the cutest little functional steam cocks on the side of the cylinders. We've got a lovely big flywheel which enables us to go nice and slow. Nice turned lever here. Beautiful light and very cute generator. So meth's firing, nice whistle, you know, tap. Look, what, there's just nothing not to like. This is a really nice model and good price. And the SE03, I saw a preview of that the other day. So I'll take you through the differences. It has a smaller whistle, not as big as this one on the SE02. It's got a much more scale whistle. The light has changed to the other style that you used to see on the German tin toys. The boiler on the new one is a vertical boiler with a center-flue and a proper glass tube, water sight glass. The engine is very similar to this one. I believe the cylinder is the same as this one, but we've got an actual working governor that throttles the steam, which I'm amazed. And instead of the little button that we've got here for turning the light on and off, which is really plasticky and crappy, we've got a beautiful rendition of a vintage knife switch to turn the light on and off. Same generator from the look of it. Yeah, so the proven parts, generator and the most of the steam engine. We've got a bigger, sort of more industrial looking flywheel, and that'll give us some nice slow running for looks, because this is a real looks kind of an engine. It's about the looks and the atmosphere of the model. Although I've had no problem running this one really nice and slow. The look of the boiler on the new one is, you know, they've put a lot of effort into that. They do put a lot of effort into the look. So you've got this brass boiler look with its rivets, what look like rivets all over it. I think they've done a really nice job of that. So I don't have this new SE03. We're looking at the video made by Stirligkit as they preview it for themselves. As of today, they haven't put it on their website, but I'm sure they will. So I don't know what the price is, but the price will be good value for money. I don't know what it is, but Stirligkit will have it at a good price, and their prices include postage. And, you know, if you're careful, you don't have to pay, you know, GST in New Zealand, VAT in England. It depends what your government does, but ours doesn't worry about small individual things from companies that aren't set up. If I got it from eBay, I would pay GST. If I get it direct from Stirligkit, I don't. So Stirligkit isn't paying me or giving me an engine for this. I'm just telling you guys what's available. The next steam engine from Retrol, and I think they're passionate. They're obviously passionate what they do. They do a good job, and if it's something you would like, I wanted to tell you about it. And if you're into steamboats, you can't really go past either Rocking Whale or OKMO. Steam engines. Now, people do go on about Chinese quality, but some Chinese quality is outstanding. This is the Rocking Whale engine, and it absolutely hums like a sewing machine.
It's running beautifully.
Made for sustained power without wearing. It is absolutely gorgeous. And not all that expensive, you know, like surprisingly inexpensive. Beautiful model. My point is, if you pay, you can get really good value from China as well as good quality. The guy who makes this is absolutely quality focused.
Other news, Jin and OKMO's micro line of Stirling engines is going to be available at Stirligkit, probably engine DIY as well. If you'd like to get your stuff with good support and postage and tax and everything included from a retailer, that will be the way to go. Nice engines. I've got a couple of these little motors and they're so cute. They run really, really well and they're very traditional construction, which is just going to last forever, unlike some of the other cheap Stirling engines out there. Real engineer's kind of a gift, I think.
The newest, smallest member of the collection. Starting to wear in.
Tigwee, that's my boy. Yeah.